Hello everyone, welcome to my tutorial today. In this tutorial, we're going to be covering the basics of Photoshop. I would love you to stay tuned for this series because we're going to be having a lot of series to talk about. And I have a book You can get it. It's very cheap. You can contact me, send me a link, and I'll send it to you. Today we're going to be talking about Photoshop. Please, if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, try to subscribe and like the post and click the bell icon to get notified of new videos. And then try to share to your friends. I believe it will be helpful to them. Now, first things first. You need to open your Adobe Photoshop. We have different versions of Adobe Photoshop. We have CC and CS. We have CC 217, 218, 219, 220, CS6, CS5, CS4. It depends on the one you're using. May I use Adobe Photoshop CC 218, 218 version. And today, whether you're using anyone, it's still the same thing. Just apply it, just look at it, you find that they are the same thing, just for the interface differences. Now, the first thing first, you need to open your Photoshop. Going to the Windows, when you look at my iPhone, you discover that I have Adobe Photoshop, Adobe software here. So once you click on the Photoshop, you give it time to open. Some take time, some don't take that much time. That's the time, so you give them to open. So once you open, the interface will look like this. Like to have a new document, like in 2019, we have the interface is very nice here. You can see that you can find the photo there. The dimensions already available for us to click on. We have for photos, prints, arts and illustration, web, mobile, film and videos. That means you can do film and videos on Adobe Photoshop. But they are not that high effects, just minor effects that you can do on there. And then at the right hand side, we have the preset details where you can put the name of the document. If you don't want, if you want to give the name now, but you can still save data to remove the name, but you can still put the name of it, then put the width and the height dimensions. Then beside the width, we have what here units in which you can put it. Maybe you want to do a job that have a custom size and you use a particular unit to measure it. Then you now click this video and then you now input the details. Then once you input the details, you can now change the details. And we have the location, we have the portrait, and we have the landscape. And you can add artboards. Then artboards gives you the ability to have more than one page in the document. But if you don't click the artboard, you only have only one workspace. But when you put this artboard, you have more than one workspace you can work on, especially when you are doing, for instance, CD jackets, or you want to do a particular design app, or you want to put content later, you want everything to go to be one app, so you can be able to monitor the flow. You can be like that. And then we have resolution. In printing, our resolution from 300 is okay for printing jobs. Then if you are doing a web job, you can use 100, 150 for web jobs like what you upload on the website to avoid the website being crunchy or slow. So you use a lower resolution. Then this resolution, there's a trick there. Like for instance, if you are going to be doing content, you know that Facebook reduces the image of stuff. When you send things on WhatsApp, it reduces the quality. So you can set to reduce the resolution high so that when you upload it, it can still be okay. But when you use like this number one, you might not like the output. And make sure that your picture is on picture and inches, not on picture centimeter. Picture and inches, don't tap out the song. Then the color code mode. The color mode, we have bitmap, grayscale, RGB, CMYK, and lab color. Now, in this grayscale, we all know it's black and white. It's like having image in the black and white form. Then RGB means red, green, and blue. Red, green, and blue. And RGB colors are used mostly for word colors. But I've discovered that in printing, RGB is kind of making mistakes. There are machines that print RGB colors. I'll start discovering them. They can print RGB colors, like in the Flex machine. Most people use RGB in DI printing. Most people use RGB and give them colors. So only this CMYK, which is the printing color, it doesn't give them that. So they use RGB colors. Then CMYK is cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. Cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. And in this cyan, most people call it sky blue. Magenta, most people call it pink. Yellow is not yellow. Then K is black. The K generally is CMYK. CMYK is used for offset printing. Like all these machine prints that go through called 201, Gestena, all these printing machines that need to pass through process of colors. They are the ones that use it. If you use RGB for offset printing, you will not like the color. It will be very, very nice. It will not be nice at all. But once you use CMYK, you discover that the color this is always active. Then we have lab color. But most times what we use is RGB and CMYK. In grayscale, later in the work you can decide to make a work grayscale or select a lab color, irrespective of the mode you're working on. But most times if you are doing something you upload online, use RGB colors because they are very nice. Then when you are, if you upload CMYK colors online, the colors will not look nice. But when you upload RGB colors online, you discover that they are very, very, very nice. So, and then from there you can put your background content, whether you want it to be white or black, like all the things you can see work on there after you know your mode of click and everything. Then once you select, let's say, let's do the print, you select A5, now we will now change the dimensions to inches, then change your dimension to. Now let's put the ad board so you understand what I'm saying. If I click activate the ad board, then it's discover here now. I have ad board 1 on top of my workspace. Then when I put a new ad board now, let me duplicate this ad board now. For instance, you see, then I will name it ad board 2. So the way you can rename it is like double clicking on the ad board here, you discover you can be able to change the name of the layer or the group to change it. You can also apply this effect to the layer. Then you see that I have two ad boards here. I can do my job here on the first ad board and work on the second ad board. Hope you understand it. So ad board is just as I say, when you want to work, have a lot of content to work with new documents. But still, what you prefer. After opening this particular document, you open another press site, and it depends on you, what you want to do, how you want to apply it. Hope you understand. So it depends on how you want to apply it. So now we go to the interface. Then, in the interface, there are a lot of things to look at. We have here the upper part that have the let's say the file, edit, this thing. You don't discover that we call it the menu bar or the main menu. The menu bar, when you click on it, you discover that things here, the menu bar. Then here you have untitled 1. This place, it is called the image display. That is the name of the document. This is your document. Drag it out, you can say this is your document, it contains the name of the document, the properties of the document. You can see RGB, we selected RGB, and this percentage is the percentage of the zoom. If I zoom, it's so I change this. But most times, this zooming of the thing doesn't work like in the default Photoshop. You have to do two preferences, but that one will come later. But let me show you how we can do it. You press Ctrl K, or you go to edit down. Code UK, then you go to your tools, then on the Photoshop tool, then you see zoom and scope will show it. So if for instance you're using the mouse, once you're creating, you discover that you can zoom and zoom out. Those of you that use Corellos will understand this. But if you're into Photoshop and you don't have this, you discover that you're having difficulty are sending those things. So now we'll take it quite a bit. In the menu bar, we'll discover that you'll see like for instance file, edit, image, layer, type, select, all these things on top of here are the menu bars. They are the menu bars. Hope you understand. And in the file, okay, let's select, let's go show you the interface before we move on. Then we have the toolbar, we have the colors, this is the color from here, we have the color, we have the layers. So you look at this stuff where my mouse is now. You start with the layer, this is where the layer is, this is the color, this is washes. There are colors, there is a family of colors, and then we have the toolbar. In this toolbar, this is what we need to do everything in Photoshop. This is where you select, you do a lot of things, right? Where the toolbar is. And then here we have the palettes. These are the palettes. So we should discover this thing. Then we have the image, the workspace. This is your workspace, this is your image. So we understand it. This is your image. So when you go to the file, we discover that we have new, and there are shortcuts attached to it. New, open, bridges, open as. New is to create a new document. Open is to open an existing document. Then open as is when you have another format that Photoshop can open. You can open it as this thing. Then open as smart object, all these things you can see converted on inside Photoshop. But smart object will not need the quality of the image. That is what about smart object. Then open recent will show you the recent jobs you've done. You can you want to open. Close is to close the particular document. Close all is to close all existing documents. So what time when you work, what you use is new, open, close, save as. Like save, you save your document, then save as if you want to get save it as a JPEG or an image or GIF or PNG, you want to save it to another format that is not PNG. That is PNG means Photoshop document. P Photoshop and Photo S Shop D document. Photoshop document. So the best save as, like I need to save it, want to send my image, my client in JPEG format. This I use save as. Then one of the things you use most times is exit. These are the most of the things. Now Photoshop is not really used for like all this graphic design and architecture is used. It's used in the architecture world and no people are using it. So Photoshop is just like a general stuff which is used in editing photos. Photoshop is a photo editing tool and it's a software that helps you to work on images, design, that is for flyer design, all post designs. Photoshop is very fast and it's very one of the most powerful tools we have in the graphic designing industry. And then we have the edit. In the edit we have undo and we have step forward and step back. For those of us that use Corel, no, the first time in shortcut is Ctrl Z. You can do that multiple times, but in Photoshop, Ctrl Z only works once. Only once. That means if you do anything in press Ctrl Z, you can't do it again. But that's the effect. They don't go step back. When you look at it here, you see alternate Ctrl Z. Alternate Ctrl Z. In the alternate Ctrl Z, it helps you to go back more than just like one color. Because that in this time around, you have to add, press all the alternate key on the keyboard. You want to control alternate. Everything and Mac, I think it's control is command there. I think you see. Go back. When you go to you're using the Mac, you go there. The shortcuts are always decided to do the work. Then cut. Cut means to copy an image without having a backup on it. Copy an image without having a backup on it. Like when you cut it, it will not be there, it will place it to somewhere else. Those of us are useful. These are normal things we use in our general system. And we have copy, we copy image, we paste image, all this menu bar. Just try to go through it you discover that there are a lot of potentials with it, then in the image, we have modes. You can change the mode of the document. We have grayscale, RGB. If you remember, during the first time when we are creating a new document, we had the opportunity to select which color code we have to work with. RGB or CMYK or lab color grayscale. And you see here, it's still here. I can change my work to CMYK. Maybe I was working, thinking that it's the work of you, the problem of the world. Then I discovered that it's something that will go on offset printing. I can easily change it to CMYK and then try to work on the tone of my color to look nice. That is one of the mode of printing. Then adjustments, I'll need to open my image to work on that. For instance, adjustments. Adjustments are to do with, we have brightness and contrast, level, curve, exposure. This thing now work with photo, the photo image. That is, you've seen the image here. Brightness and contrast, you know what brightness and contrast is. To increase the brightness of something, let's click on it. We increase the brightness, you see it, and we increase the contrast. That is the work of it. That is for brightness and contrast. And then we have levels. Levels also used to increase the brightness and the dark part of the image. You see, if you want to, for instance, let's close it and open it. You want to darken this image, like to bring out the black part of it, which is it becomes black. So black has to overshadow everything. And if you want it just to be white, you see white. So level doesn't work with white and black. And in the channels, you see you can select the color. Like you are opening an image, this image is RGB image. So you can decide to increase the red, reduce it, or increase the red. So just for you to increase the level of the color that an image has. So if you want to increase the red color, you can, although there are still many ways to do it, because Photoshop has a lot of ways to do stuff here, so you can see the right for levels. Then we have curves. When you click on the curve, you can increase, you can see what it does, and you can, most times we use it on increasing the sharpness of the color of the image. Let's say you can select the color of the edge, for instance, you grab it up. So you're using the color, same thing that's ready. Then, one good thing about this is that it's like a graph. You can, the photos of us are into mathematics, you know that in the graph, you can increase it and you can reduce it. It works like a graph. Okay, understand? It's more like a graph. So this way you can be able to work and tune your color depending on what you want to do. Right for it. Then we have vibrance and all these things. Just try to get my ebook. Just try to order my ebook. I've missed around and the same thing media. You can check me out the same thing here. Discover that. I'll send you the page, it's just a small token page, so you can go through this menu because I can't go through everything now. Only where I'll be coming to touch it is when I need to be doing something and you need to play it. But yourself, you can go around and see what it's all about. For now, we are going to be ending our tutorial here. Hope you liked it a lot, hope it was helpful. This is part one of the tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll continue from where we stop. Thanks for watching. Please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel and share this video to your friends and invite your friends to get my YouTube channel. Thanks.